Rowen, you're back. Lady Drizelle has been worried sick about you. Please, pay her a visit so she knows you're okay.
Why, I intend to do just that. Ah, Luga, I should probably explain. I once served Lady Drizelle. She's an heiress of the Cheryl family that has long ruled this city. I was just about to visit the manor and pay my regards to her, in fact.
Hey, we want to go! I want to see her too! You should come with us! I'm glad you're coming with us! Luger will do our bidding!
It's settled then. Pardon me a moment. I must respond to this text.
Look at those fingers fly!
Do forgive me. I assure you, we can trust Lady Drizelle completely. Regardless of your nationality, I know that she will welcome you with open arms.
Drizelle is my best friend in the whole world.
She works really hard, and she's super nice.
You're an interesting person. You know all sorts of things. And, well, I feel like I can really count on you.
Here, from Elisa's heart.
I hope we can get to know each other even better.
Since you took that, you're obligated now.
Oh, I beg your pardon. I've just remembered an urgent errand. Please, go on ahead without me. I'll follow shortly.
What is it?
Oh, nothing important. It won't take but a moment.
He sure left in a hurry.
What's old Beardo up to?
Lately, Rowen disappears for periods of time without telling anybody. And sometimes, he comes back injured. We can always visit Drizelle. I think we should go follow after Rowen. Let's hurry. He went towards the Colmar Trail.
Guess who just got stronger?
Come and get it! From looting at me!
I'm here for you!
Fire!
come and give me your best shot.
Luga, I wish you'd gone ahead as I asked. I shall feel this tomorrow, but no injuries of consequence, thank you.
Did these people attack you? But why?
They're from a group of extremists who oppose peace between the realms. They don't seem particularly fond of me. I took the opportunity to settle our political differences, at their insistence, of course. Now that the schism is gone, I can't imagine any positive future without peace between the two nations. The fostering of that future, to see people united as one, is my last and final duty to this world. At my age, I have little time for regrets. I will give this cause everything I have.
Yeah.
Pardon me, I've received another message. Ah, if it isn't Marcia.
Marcia the Chancellor?
You two are pen pals?
Incidentally, yes. I reached out to her after the last Fractured Dimension incident. I'm happy to say that now we like to exchange messages from time to time. It's not like we're exchanging state secrets. We just discuss the works of Bradbury and such. Charming.
So, what does the message say?
I'll read it aloud.
We've received intel that Olympian extremists intend to make an attempt on your life. Please respond with your current whereabouts immediately. I will do everything I can to help.
You sure are Mr. Unpopularity.
Wait, but help's on the way, right?
No help will be forthcoming. I have declined her offer.
You declined?
What? Are you nuts?
I know that she means well, and for that I am most grateful. Yet I fear the opponents of peace might take advantage of the situation to undermine the diplomatic process. Therefore, I shall handle this myself.
Huh? They're already here?
Things are moving too fast! Who are they?
Just your everyday invaders.
Every day? I don't want to have it every day. You did it!
Please provide support.
Why did this happen?
Sorry to get you all involved.
It's okay.
We're just upset you hid this from us.
I'll keep getting better.
Hey! You better not underestimate me.
It seems we all made it.
That was scary. Oh. Thanks.
Oh. Chancellor Marcia.
What's it say?
Part of me wants to call you a fool, but I know that's not true. I had the same concerns as you. Be safe, Rowen. I look forward to sitting opposite each other at the next diplomatic conference. P.S. You're a most impressive man, as is this King Gaius you so honorably serve.
It sounds like you've really gotten the Chancellor to trust you and Gaius.
How I wish I could believe that.
He's right. At your age, you need all the heart you've got left.
After all, widespread joy is a greater joy for all. right?
Thank you, everyone. Now, I do believe we are late for an appointment with Lady Drizelle.
Let's not keep her waiting!
How did you...
Ellie! And Rowen, too! It's so good to be home!
You both look well. What a relief!
We happen to be in the neighborhood, so we thought we might impose upon you for a moment.
You know you're always welcome here. And you too, Luger.
What about me and Rolo?
Of course! I'm delighted to see you too! You have the best timing. I've been planning a little activity I was hoping to share with you.
An activity?
What do you have planned, m'lady?
Well, you see...
Ooh, what could it be?
It's a time capsule!
A time capsule?
Of course. The more, the merrier.
What's a time capsule?
It's a casket filled with all sorts of items. We'll bury it and dig it up years from now for nostalgia's sake. It's great fun.
Hey, that does sound like fun.
But why the sudden interest in time capsules?
It's not sudden. I've been planning this for ages. I wanted to do something together that we'd all remember.
Something unforgettable. I love it.
Then it's settled. Everyone, pick something you're willing to part with for a while.
What should we bury?
How about you, Tipo?
No way! I'm claustrophobic!
What should I choose?
The harder your decision, the more memorable it'll be.
Very well said, Lady Drizelle.
Okay, go figure out what you'd like to have buried, everyone. Have you decided what you want to put in the capsule? Great! Everyone's ready! Let's bury the capsule right here.
How long do you intend to leave it buried, Lady Drizelle?
Good question. I figure an even decade will do.
10 years.
You'll be a grown-up, Elise!
Me too!
I'm afraid I might not be around.
Hush, Rowen. This just means you're stuck staying alive for at least another decade. I expect you back here in 10 years, no matter what!
Lady Drizelle...
That's an order!
Yes, mistress.
10 years. I hope the time flies by. I wonder what the world will be like then.